Well, the Sabres are on the move, and Rick has that story.
Yeah, they're on the move to Boston for Game 5 of the series with the Bruins. An accomplishment when you consider the Sabres lost the first two games in Boston by a total of 7 goals. But things evened out here in Buffalo. Sabres winning a slugfest Saturday and an overtime gem last night. Tucker and Turgeon have starred, but guys like Mark Napier are playing a big part in making it happen.
It's been fun playing with Johnny Tucker the way he's been playing. He's, you know, him and Davey have pretty well played together all year long, and we just made the change when we lost the two games in Boston, and Tuck got fired. I kind of kid him that I take credit for getting him going, but it's not me at all. Johnny's been playing great, and I've just been along for the ride. It's been a lot of fun.
He and Clark Gillies, you know, we were calling that Stanley Cup experience, and we're looking around the room in the overtime, and a lot of guys are white knuckles, and you hear the voices of Clark Gillies and Mark Napier telling the guys, you might as well get used to these because you're going to be playing a few of them in the Stanley Cups. And when you have that class and that experience talking, it's a big boost for us.
Now, whether Tom Barrasso will be available for Game 5 is still undetermined, but Jay Miller, Lyndon Byers, and Bruce Shoebottom will miss Game 5 tomorrow because of injury. Could be a quiet game, thank goodness. The Buffalo Bills have announced the signing of Earl Tucker. He's a defensive back and punt returner from Utah. Tucker's previous pro experience was with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Take a look at the Eastern Division standings in the American League tomorrow morning, but don't call the paper claiming a misprint. It's true. The Cleveland Indians are in first place. They got there because of a couple of things happened today. For one, the Indians won their sixth in a row, beating Baltimore 7-2. Former Bison Dave Clark gave the Indians the lead in the sixth inning with a game-winning RBI. Later in that same inning, Corey Snyder, who had double, stole home for a 4-2 Indians lead. They scored three more in the seventh, handed the Orioles their sixth straight loss. The final again, the Indians 7, Orioles 2. Meanwhile, the Yankees were losing their first game of the year, and that's why the Indians are now in first place with a 6-1 record. Yankees are 5-1. Yankees led 3-0 going to the bottom of the first in Toronto. Rick Beach's double down the right field line made it 5-3. Blue Jays. Leach got home on a Tommy John Wild pitch later on, and it was 6-3 after just one inning of play. Didn't stop. Kelly Gruber, another former Bison, slammed a pair of homers. One came in the seventh inning, and then he came up again in the eighth, and he hit another one. And when the dust settled, the Blue Jays had slugged the Yankees 17-9 in their home opener. National League action, Pittsburgh beat Philadelphia 5-1. The Cubs over St. Louis 6-1. Cincinnati leading San Francisco 4-0 in the eighth inning. Houston, Atlanta postponed because of rain, as was the Bisons game in Nashville. They'll try again tomorrow. In the NBA, the New York Knicks, with Gerald Wilkins making a steal and a jam early in the game against Detroit, are making a strong bid for a playoff spot. Patrick Ewing led the Knicks with 36 as they beat the Pistons 114-111 in overtime. Isaiah Thomas, with 4 seconds left, got the bucket to send it into overtime, but Ewing's roll-around bucket was the winning shot, making the score 112-111 with 24 seconds left. Pistons didn't score again, and the Knicks got the two more. Final there, again, 114-111 in overtime. Washington beat Atlanta 86-85. Indiana handed New Jersey their 11th straight loss, 95-93. Philadelphia beat Milwaukee 115-102. Denver over Phoenix 123-119, and Utah over Golden State 113-102. The NCAA men's and women's basketball champions were the guests of honor at the White House today. Kansas Jayhawks, who beat Oklahoma to take the title last Monday night, were treated to a reception, and they presented a Jayhawks jacket to the president. The Louisiana Tech women's champions were also honored, sharing the limelight in the White House garden ceremony. They defeated Auburn to win the NCAA women's title. Daily double at Batavia Downs, 5-4, returned $22.20 tonight. Seventh race trifecta, a biggie. Look at this, 3-7-2, paid $2,328. And the 11th race trifecta, 2-7-4, $2,297. Gee, I wish I'd had a couple of dollars on that.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Thanks, Rick. Still ahead, Rex Reed guessed wrong, and Lori has the late, 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 late weather. Finally, police in Irving, Texas busted a counterfeit money ring the other day. Police were tipped off to the bogus bills by a grocery store clerk who was given a $20 bill. The clerk said, "I didn't think it was genuine. One of Andrew Jackson's eyes was looking at the ceiling, and the other one was looking at the floor.
That's a good way to tell.
Incidentally, we wanted to mention that at tonight's Academy Award presentations, Paul Holman, a local gentleman, did all the laser
work. Oh, well, that's
work.
Great.
So no, that, isn't terrific. That terrific? And hey, 6 out of 6.
Oh,
when's the last time you did that?
I hear this for a long time.
Here's ABC.